Namaskar. The topic of discussion in this module is on the Pacific Ocean. If we look at the globe, the world's major continents divide the ocean water masses into 5 parts. They are the Pacific Ocean, the Atlantic Ocean, the Indian Ocean, the Arctic Ocean, and the Antarctic Ocean. Each one of these oceans include many smaller bodies of water called as seas, gulfs, bays, and straits. Among these huge water masses, the Pacific Ocean is the largest and the deepest in the world. Geographically, the Pacific Ocean alone covers about 32% of the Earth's surface. It is almost 46% of all the total area occupied by the seas and oceans. The surface area of the Pacific Ocean is greater than that of all the land areas put together. The understanding of the Pacific Ocean is an interesting part in the subject of oceanography. The Portuguese explorer Ferdinand Magellan named this great oceanic water mass as the Pacific Ocean. The name is derived from the Latin term Mare Pacificum, which means peaceful sea. The Pacific is a very vast ocean. It is spread over an area of 165 million square kilometers. Depth wise also, it is the deepest ocean in the world. The mean depth of the Pacific Ocean is 4,280 meters. The Pacific and its marginal seas cover about 180 million square kilometers in the world. It is the largest water body of the hydrosphere. It extends from the Arctic of the North Pole to the Antarctic region of the South Pole. It is located between North and South America on the east and Asia, Japan and Australia and the New Zealand on the west. It is one ocean with innumerable marine biological and geological features. The Pacific Ocean is connected with the Arctic Ocean by the Bering Strait, with the Atlantic Ocean by the Drake Passage at the southern end of the South America, Straits of Magellan and the Panama Canal, and with the Indian Ocean by the passages in the Malay Archipelago, Torres Strait between Australia and Papua New Guinea. Its maximum north-south length is about 14,500 kilometers and its greatest east-west width is about 17,700 kilometers between the isthmus of Panama and the Malay Peninsula. It extends approximately 15,500 kilometers from the Bering Sea in the Arctic of the North Pole to the northern extent of the Southern Ocean at 60 degrees south. The Pacific reaches its greatest east-west width at about 5 degrees north latitude, where it stretches approximately 19,800 kilometers from Indonesia to the coast of Colombia and Peru, halfway across the world. The equator subdivides the Pacific Ocean into the North Pacific Ocean and South Pacific Ocean. The principal arms of the Pacific Ocean are the Bering Sea in the north, the Gulf of California in the east, the Ross Sea in the south, and the Sea of Okhotsk, the Sea of Japan, the Yellow Sea, East China Sea, South China Sea, Philippine Sea, Coral Sea, and the Tasman Sea in the west. Let us see the depth zones of the Pacific. The depth zones of the Pacific are very unique features. The Pacific is the deepest ocean in the world. It has an average depth of 3,940 meters. Its mean depth is also the greatest among the three major oceans of the world. The total volume of water existing in Pacific is about 53% of the total volume of all the oceans put together. Its greatest depth lies within the Mariana Trench and the Japan Trenches. These two are the world's deepest trenches, reaching a depth of more than 10,000 meters. The Mariana Trench is in the western North Pacific Ocean. This is the deepest point in not only in the Pacific, but also in the whole world. The maximum depth measured is 10,911 meters. The deepest known point on the earth is the Mariana Trench. It lies at 10,911 meters below the sea level. The deepest parts of the Pacific are nearer to the shores. They include the Japan and Kuril trenches, which border the island chains of the Western Pacific. Plate tectonics is a notable theory explaining the origin of continents and ocean basins. According to the theory of plate tectonics, the Earth's outer shell consists of huge rigid plates that move continuously. As the plates move, they carry the ocean floor and the continents with them. The relative movement of two neighboring plates is generally about 1 to 10 centimeters a year. The plates move away from one another along the divergent plate boundaries. At the same time, they must move toward one another along the convergent plate boundaries elsewhere. When two plates collide each other, one plate may pile up against the other. This created the underwater mountains. Sometimes one plate may be drawn down into the mantle under the other plate. Such action produces deep oceanic trenches and generate volcanic eruptions. Earthquakes also occur near these plate boundaries. Different movements of the plates have different effects on the ocean bottom. Sea floor spreading and the formation of new sea floors occur where the plates move apart. The mid-ocean ridges also mark the existence of such zones. The Pacific Ocean is currently shrinking due to the theory of plate tectonics. It shrinks by roughly an inch per year, that is 2 to 3 centimeters per year on three sides. It amounts to an average of 0.5 square kilometer per year, that is the rate in which Pacific Ocean is shrinking. The great ocean explorations have several links to the study of Pacific Ocean. The early migrants crossed the long distance of the open Pacific Ocean using primitive boats and ships. The Pacific islands of the south and west were populated by these migrants mainly derived from the Asia. The European travelers, including Marco Polo, had reported an ocean off Asia in the late 15th century. Some trading ships had also sailed around Africa to the western rim of the Pacific during this time. The true recognition of the Pacific as a distinct ocean from that of the Atlantic Ocean came after Balboa's sighting of its eastern shore during the year 1513. The world famous voyages of Pacific Islanders have given the inputs and all practical knowledge about oceanography to the rest of the world. Many brave men, successful technology and dogged persistence of Pacific exploration all have made it possible to reach to every area of the world afterwards. The morphology and relief of the Pacific Ocean have shown various unique features. The ocean floor is a region of spectacular morphology and contrasting relief features in the Pacific. Beneath the sea, there are broad plains covering huge distances, towering mountain chains, undersea volcanoes, and deep trenches and valleys. The continental shelf is the submerged land at the edge of the continents. It begins at the shoreline and gently slopes underwater to an average depth of about 130 meters. The width of the continental shelf averages 75 kilometers. The edge of the shelf occurs at a depth that ranges from 20 to 550 meters. The shelf consists of vast deposits of sands, mud and gravels overlaying the crystalline rocks or the vast thicknesses of consolidated sedimentary rocks. The edge of the shelf, called as the shelf break, is marked by an abrupt increase in the slope to an average of about 4 degrees. The shelf is followed by the continental slope. The slope is much steeper than the shelf and plunges to depths of 3.6 kilometers. The slope forms in effect the sides of the continents. Its width ranges from 20 to 100 kilometers. In many places, deep underwater canyons gash the slope. The continental slopes begin at the shelf break and plunge downwards to the great depths of the ocean basin properly. Deep submarine canyons are sometimes found cutting across the shelf and slope, often extending from the mouths of terrestrial rivers. The following are the notable submarine canyons of the Pacific Ocean: the Bering Canyon, the Monterey Canyon, the Navarin Canyon, the Pribilof Canyon, Scripps Canyon, and the Jemshug Canyon. Three of the largest submarine canyons in the world are incised into the Beringian margin of the Bering Sea. Monterey Canyon is the largest and deepest submarine canyon off the Pacific coast of North America. Pribilof is a long submarine canyon rising from the Bering abyssal plain on the floor of the Bering Sea. It is located southeast of the Pribilof Islands, North Alaska. Scripps Canyon is a shallow marine submarine canyon in the Pacific off La Jolla in California. The valleys are 12 meters deep. The maximum depth goes up to 300 meters. The Veracruz Canyon is an underwater canyon located off the eastern coast of Mexico in the Gulf of Mexico, not far from the port city of Veracruz. The continental slope is very near to the coastline in almost all surrounding countries of the Pacific. The deep ocean floor begins at the seaward edge of the continent slope and rises. Vast abyssal plains mostly cover significant portions of the deep ocean basin. The abyssal plains cover nearly 75% of the Pacific Ocean floors. They are among the flattest portions of the Earth's crust and appears to be formed by the deposition of fine sediments carried by turbidity currents. These sediments have covered and smoothed out the irregularities in the morphology of the ocean floor. The thick sediment deposits of the continental rise extend up to 1000 kilometers from the slope. Deep sea peaks, valleys, and plains lie beyond the continental margin in the ocean basins. The mid-ocean ridges form a chief feature of the deep ocean basin. The ridges consist of a chain of mountains that runs about 60,000 kilometers throughout the three major oceans in the world. Scientists discovered the mountain chain independently in each ocean and gave it different names, including Mid-Atlantic Ridge, East Pacific Rise, and the Mid-Indian Ridges. Most mountains of the mid-ocean ridges stand about 1500 meters above the sea floor. Deep valleys cut across the ridges in many places, producing a rugged, fractured surface. Frequent volcanic activity occurs along such central valleys. One of the most surprising findings of the early oceanographers was that the deepest parts of the oceans were not in the centers of the oceans as they had expected, but they were in fact quite close to the margins of the continents, particularly in the Pacific Ocean. Further exploration have also shown that these deeps were located in long V-shaped trenches bordering the seaward edges of the volcanic island arcs. These trenches are one of the most striking features of the Pacific floor. Trenches virtually encircle the rim of the Pacific basin. The trenches have lengths of thousands of kilometers or generally hundreds of kilometers wide and extend 3 to 4 kilometers deeper than the surrounding ocean floor. The notable trenches of the Pacific Ocean are the Mariana Trench, the Tonga Trench, the Philippine Trench, the Kuril Kamchatka Trench, the Kermadec Trench, Izu Ogaswara Trench, Japan Trench, Yap Trench, Peru Chile Trench, Aleutian Trench, Middle America Trench, Paisigur Trench, Vityas Trench, and Ryukyu Trench. The greatest ocean depth has been sounded in the Challenger Deep of the Mariana Trench at a distance of about 10,911 meters below the sea level. The Pacific Ocean contains several long seamount chains formed by hotspot volcanism. These include the Hawaiian Emperor Seamount Chain and the Lausville Seamount Chain. Bathymetric profiles from the Pacific have shown 10,000 seamounts with more than 1 kilometer elevation. The notable seamounts of the Pacific Ocean are Patten seamounts, Covey seamounts, Lord Howe seamounts, Gilbert seamounts, Marten seamounts, Union seamount, Cobb seamount, Dickin seamount, Mathematician seamount, Clipperton seamount, Milwaukee seamount and Mapmaker seamounts, Mid Pacific seamount, Marshall seamount, Gifford seamount, Urban seamount, Welker Guyot, Lynn Guyot, Pratt seamount, Parker seamount, Hess Guyot and the Valerie Guyots. These are the very notable seamounts and guyots in the Pacific Ocean. One of the most striking features of the ocean floor is the distribution of mid-ocean ridges. These ridges are mountain-like structures standing well above the deep ocean floors. The Pacific Ocean has the following notable ridges: Gorda ridges, Kyushu Palau ridges, South Honshu ridge, West Norfolk ridge and Norfolk ridge, Kermadec ridge, Robbie ridge, Hawaiian ridge, Christmas ridge and Necker ridge, Tehantepec ridge, Colon ridge, Pacific Antarctica ridge, Nazca ridge, Society ridge, Tomato ridge, Macquarie ridge, Carolin ridge and the Galapagos ridge. These are the notable ridges of the Pacific Ocean. The Pacific Ocean has got a lot of islands. The Pacific alone contains about 25,000 islands. It is more than the total number of islands seen combined in the other parts of the world. The majority of these islands are found south of the equator. In the southwestern corner of the Pacific lie the islands of Melanesia, dominated by the New Guinea. The other important island groups of the Melanesia include the Bismarck Archipelago, Fiji, New Caledonia, the Solomon Islands and the Vanuatu Islands. Islands in the Pacific are of four basic types as continental islands, high islands, coral reefs and uplifted coral platforms. The continental islands lie outside the andesite line and include New Guinea, the islands of New Zealand and the Philippines. Some of these islands are structurally associated with the nearby continents. High islands are of volcanic in origin and many contain active volcanoes. Among these are the Bougainville Island of the Hawaii and the Solomon Islands. The third and fourth types of islands are both originated due to the coral growth. Coral reefs are low-lying underwater structures that have built up on the basaltic lava flows of the ocean surfaces. One of the most dramatic is the Great Barrier Reef off the northeastern coast of Australia. The climate of the Pacific is greatly influenced by the following features: the planetary air pressure systems, the trade winds and the westerly winds, the tropical cyclones, which includes the hurricanes and typhoons, the continental influences and the monsoonal rainy seasons. The planetary air pressure systems and resultant wind patterns exhibit remarkable uniformity in the climatic conditions of the south and the east. The trade winds and the westerly winds are well developed patterns modified by seasonal fluctuations. Tropical cyclones may form south of Mexico from June to October and affect Mexico and Central America every year. The western Pacific is monsoonal with a rainy season occurring during the summer months when moisture laden winds blow from the ocean over the land. The tropical cyclones including typhoons may strike Southeast and East Asia from May to December. The volume of the Pacific Ocean is approximately 622 million cubic kilometers. Water temperatures in the Pacific vary from freezing in the poleward areas to about 30 degrees Celsius near the equator. Salinity also varies with reference to latitude. The water near the equator is less salty than the one found in the mid latitudes because of the abundant equatorial precipitation throughout the year. Because of the vast majority of the world's ocean volume, the mean temperature of seawater is low. About 75% of the ocean's volume has a temperature ranging from 0 to 5 degrees Celsius. The same percentage falls within a salinity range between 34 to 35 ppt. The surface temperatures can range from below freezing point near the poles to 35 degrees in the restricted tropical seas, while the salinity can also vary from 10 to 41 ppt. The western tropical Pacific has the warmest surface waters. The ocean currents in the Pacific are unique features. The waters of the Pacific Ocean move constantly. Two types of circulation create the currents in the ocean. They are the wind driven circulation and the thermohaline circulation. The wind driven circulation results from the wind blowing on the ocean surface. Wind driven currents move in enormous circular patterns called gyres. The gyres flow clockwise in the subtropics of the northern hemisphere and anti-clockwise in the subtropics of the southern hemisphere. There are two major wind systems driving the waters of the Pacific Ocean. They are the westerlies and the trade winds. The motion of the Pacific waters is generally clockwise in the northern hemisphere and counterclockwise in the southern hemisphere. The north equatorial current driven westward along latitude 15 degrees north by the trade winds turns north near the Philippines to become the warm Japan or Kuroshio current. Turning eastward at about 45 degrees north, the Kuroshio forks and some waters move northwards as the Aleutian currents. The south equatorial current flowing west along the equator swings southward east of New Guinea, turns east at about 50 degrees south and joins the main westerly circulation of the southern Pacific, which includes the east circling Antarctic circumpolar current. As it approaches the Chilean coast, the south equatorial current divides. One branch flows around Cape Horn and the other turns north to form the Peru or the Humboldt current. The marine life in the Pacific Ocean are also unique features. The Pacific Ocean has an incredible variety of living things. These marine life ranges in size from microscopic one-celled organisms to the blue whale, which may measure up to 30 meters long. They are divided into three groups as the plankton, nekton and the benthos. Fish are the most important animals of the nekton. About 13,300 kinds of fish live in the Pacific Ocean. Squids are free swimming mollusks that have 10 arms. Nektonic mammals include dugongs, manatees, porpoises and whales, all of which remain in the ocean all their lives. The other marine mammals include the sea lions, sea otters, seals and walruses. Most of them spend their time on the land also. The Pacific's greatest asset is its fish population. The shoreline waters of the continents and the more temperature islands yielding herring salmon, sardines, snappers, swordfishes and tuna, as well as the shellfishes. The mineral resources of the Pacific Ocean are yet another important features. The exploitation of the Pacific mineral wealth is hampered by the ocean's great depths. In shallow waters of the continental shelves off the coast of Australia and New Zealand, petroleum and natural gas are extracted. Pearls are harvested along the coasts of Australia, Japan, Papua New Guinea, Nicaragua, Panama and the Philippines. The mineral wealth of the ocean extends to the deep sea floor. Deposits near undersea hot springs contain copper, iron and zinc. The time zones of the world is also related to the Pacific Ocean. The 180 degree meridian passes through the Pacific Ocean. It is called as the international dateline. It is where each day begins. The commerce and shipping part of Pacific Ocean is yet another feature to study. Strategically important access waterways along the Pacific includes the La Perouse, Sugaru, Tsushima, Taiwan, Singapore and Torres Straits. The Pacific Ocean has been a highway for trade since people built the first ships thousands of years ago. Today, transportation remain an important use of the ocean. Ports and terminals of the Pacific Ocean are Bangkok in Thailand, Hong Kong in China, Kaohsiung in Taiwan, Los Angeles in US, Manila in the Philippines, Busan in South Korea, San Francisco in US, Seattle in US, Shanghai in China, Singapore, Sydney in Australia, Vladivostok in Russia, Wellington in New Zealand and Yokohama in Japan. In addition to this, Pacific also experiences several natural hazards. The Pacific is surrounded by a zone of violent volcanic and earthquake activity. Hence, it is referred to as Pacific Ring of Fire. The Pacific is also subjected to frequent tropical cyclones in the southeast. Most of them are typhoons. Tropical cyclones including hurricanes may form south of Mexico and strike the Central America and Mexico from June to October every year. Cyclical El Nino and La Nina phenomena occur in the equatorial Pacific, influencing the weather in the western hemisphere and also the western Pacific. Ships are subjected to superstructure icing in extreme north from October to May. There are several problems encountered in the Pacific Ocean. Marine pollution is a generic term for the harmful entry into the ocean of chemicals or particles. The Pacific is no exception to all kinds of pollutants entering into the sea. Oil is a major source of ocean pollution. Most oil pollution enters the ocean from oil spills on land or in rivers used to transport petroleum. Ocean dumping is yet another problem of the Pacific. The deliberate dumping of waste products into it is another major source of ocean pollution. Such products include industrial waste and sewage. Industries dump chemicals, animal and plant matter and other pollutants into the ocean. Throughout the history, humans have been directly or indirectly influenced and benefited by the oceans. Ocean waters serve as a source of food and valuable mineral deposits. The Pacific Ocean is a home for the millions. People have lived within and sailed over the waters of the Pacific Ocean for thousands of years. Its contribution to the global climate and weather is profound. It has a great history in the world history of science, technology, commerce, and trade.